a Porsche e-hybrid workshop in Frankfurt. Fuel consumption and CO2 emissions are the industry's hot topics. And as an innovative sports car maker, Porsche wants to leave others in its dust here too. So it's also rolling the new Cayenne out in an SE-hybrid version. Question is, do Porsche and plug-in hybrids really go together? Stefan Fegg says besides making emission-free and silent driving possible, the e-hybrid's electric drive can also support the combustion engine, making additional electrical energy available to enable some very sporty driving. The Cayenne's plug-in hybrid engine combines purely electrical driving even across long distances, along with an economical gasoline-powered engine. Its main advantage, lower emissions, without sacrificing the famous Porsche performance. The hybrid technological highlight is the Porsche 918 super sports car.
The hybrid concept is normally associated to cheap cars or cars too slow, too boring, and this is the opportunity to demonstrate another chance, another phase of the technology. It's very impressive for me that Porsche have this kind of a car, a sport car.
On the track, the 918 Spider demonstrates that even super sports cars can reach new heights of performance through hybrid technology. Its unique all-wheel drive concept unites a combined electrical and combustion engine on the rear axle and a second electric motor on the front axle. The Cayenne SE Hybrid relies on more than its sporting pedigree. With its 36-kilometer range, the e-drive opens new possibilities for drivers, for instance when driving silently off-road so as not to disturb the local wildlife with engine noise. The battery can, of course, be charged while driving, but the SE Hybrid can also juice up at a charging station. Drivers can use the facility by entering a special code. The charging socket is found on the driver's side. Porsche's Martin Guttmann says the new e-hybrid has a much larger battery and a higher performance e-engine. The advantage for customers is being able to drive electrically up to 36 kilometers in the city and have a 3.4-liter fuel consumption rate according to the new European standard. That's the theory. With 306 kilowatts of performance, slightly less than that of the Cayenne S, the SE Hybrid costs €82,087. That's 2,000 more than the Cayenne S. The hybrid sprints from 0 to 100 kmh in 5.9 seconds, but can the driver resist temptation and hold consumption below 4 litres? During the workshop, Porsche let the journalists try.
I'd like to go quickly through the consumption figures that you achieved on the way here. So, as you don't see them, it's 4.1, 4.3, 3.8 and 6.0 in the different teams of the Cayenne.
I think I really enjoy it when the engine starts still, but I think the hybrid technology is what we will see more of in the future, definitely.
It's quite unique to have a car that doesn't say anything when you drive it in the e-hybrid, and then you can turn it to the engine and still experience this fantastic Porsche feeling when you drive. So both modes are quite fantastic, I think.
Well, there's no denying it's a Porsche. It drives like a Porsche, and it does exactly what you want it to do. It turns nicely, it brakes nicely, it's got a perfect balance. And the fact that it's a combination of hybrid driver and electric and combustion engine doesn't really affect the driving appeal of the car. So it's a very nice, nicely put together package.
Future generations of Porsche sports cars are sure to benefit from today's e-hybrid progress. Porsche and hybrid fit together hand in glove. Even the sports car maker's founder, Ferdinand Porsche, experimented with hybrid drive.